Beloved, remember this, wherever you are, wherever you may be, right there is a door into your inmost being. Enter fully the deep blue of infinite being. Merge yourself in the vibration of these heart songs, where you will find yourself one with truth, peace, and grace. Om. It's end stick for you.
Let the music rhyme and melody soothe your soul and boost your energy. See?
We have an appointment to meet the Buddha in this place. Buddha, where are you? Buddha, where are you? Why you pretend? Why you hide? Slowly coming out.
Inna peace, them the thing that we need to increase. Are the inna peace, inna peace, inna peace. Them the thing that we need to increase. Are the inna peace, inna peace.
We are this. It's not even that you have a choice to be this. It simply is, and what is, there's no choice about. It is or it's not. It's that. But somehow it has to come to itself consciously. Yeah. Buddha, where are you? Where are you? Why you pay so much attention to all these things? You're the one who sees them. You see their comings and their goings. But you who see them, can you be seen? Buddha, where are you? Buddha, where are you? Why you pretend? Why you hide?
Whether you're white, black, Asian, or coolie,
send stick for you.
Inner peace will set you free truly. Listen the words of Ayman and Moody. Inner peace. Them the thing that we need to increase. And the inner peace. Inner peace.
We have an appointment to meet the Buddha in this place. Buddha, where are you? Buddha, where are you? Why you pretend? Why you hide? Slowly coming out.
Inner peace. Them the thing that we need to increase. And the inner peace. Inner peace. Inner peace. Them the thing that we need to increase. And the inner peace. Inner peace. Listen the words of Ayman and Moody. Whether you're white, black, Asian, or coolie,
it's end stick for you.
Inner peace will set you free truly.
It's end stick for you.
Listen the words of Ayman and Moody.
It's end stick for you. If only one question I had to have for you, forget everything else, I'll ask you this question. And I'll keep asking you. I'll keep asking this question. I will see the one in whom this question fully happens. If your existence is merely to satisfy your projections, to want something, to want some special effects, to want some object, to want relationship, to want success in the material world, to want to learn a few supernatural tricks, then this is different. If it is within you to discover your own Buddha nature, your own Christ consciousness, Krishna consciousness, your own self, then you cannot turn away from this question. Everything is in this question. Everything else is secondary. There is no need, no criteria to try and feel like everybody else, to try and see that all the world is one. There's no need for this. That may be revealed spontaneously by itself. Don't work for it. Only find out who you are. Now. Can you be the idea you have of yourself? Your education, gender, nationality, that which is affected by the planets. Can you be this? And this discovery is available right now. Even the allowing of the question is doing its work. Without the help of your mind, it's doing its work. Is there enjoyment for one who is free? Of course there's enjoyment. Enjoyment is not the monopoly of the mind or ego. Your entire being is synonymous with joy. But enjoy being free. At the highest level, one is only enjoying oneself. At lower levels, you're enjoying, you need some object to enjoy, something to enjoy, some relationship to enjoy. And that's fine, because that's also joy. But at the truest space, the self is enjoying itself. Manifested as all of this, but even without tying itself to any object or any goal, this joy which is not about something, the joy which is synonymous with being, the joy of being, in fact everything is the joy of being. Even the sense of the joy of becoming arises out of the joy of being. Only one who is free is not pursuing this. Does not have to go even to other. Even the sense of other is seen as it is still the same one. It is my hope that as you listen, that somehow it brings about intuitive recognition within your own self. Not collecting information, I'm not interested in information. But somehow that through recognition, there is a filtering out, a combing out of that identification which is the cause of all that noise. All confusion comes out of this to show you you have never been that. Just this is imagined in ourselves. We learn so many concepts which are not in service to the truth that we are. This is all. What will be the outcome of this recognition? Unbroken silence and stillness. Unbroken joy. Such joy that even has space for sadness to appear in it. For the play of irritation, momentary anger can happen in it. But they cannot linger in it. Because it is the unbroken joy of being. Even now, here, it is revealing itself. Even now, here, it is breaking through its own imagined boundaries to reveal itself to itself.
Is this loving? Is this love? Is this love? Is this love that I'm feeling?
Your entire being is synonymous with joy.
Is this love? Is this love? Is this love? Is this love that I'm feeling?
One is only enjoying oneself.
Throw my cards on your table.
higher being is synonymous with joy. One is only enjoying oneself.
Table. See, I wanna love you, I wanna love and treat you right. I wanna love you every day and every night. We'll be together with the roof right over our heads. We'll share the shelter.
Falling through a hole in the universe.
that's required is to know what you are. That's all. Another thing. As long as there is breath inside this body, the life force, and this body and consciousness is there, the potential for some thought activity or for sentiments, it will come. You cannot help it. It will just happen. And there's no need to try and stop it from happening. All that's required is to know what you are. That's all. If you don't know, you're going to be going around without fires that you didn't start. If you know what you are, you can leave them. And they will go out by themselves. They will go out by themselves. Because this fire does not feed on wood. It feeds on your interest. About this thing and so on. All that's required is to know what you are. That's all. Because if it was up to us to design the life you think is best for you, nobody would include anything uncomfortable. It would all be chocolate flavored moments. Thankfully, life has another another cooking. And only you are grateful only from hindsight. Most of the greatest things that happened for you that pushed you into seeing, you are grateful in hindsight. When you look back, you say, yeah, actually, that was good. It was good that this happened, but it would not be chosen. You look back in gratitude. You look back in gratitude. You see? All that's required is to know what you are. That's all. If you don't know, you're going to be going around trying to put out fires that you didn't start. If you know what you are, you can leave them. And they will go out by themselves. They will go out by themselves.
Catch it at the root. We're just here to hatch. We're just here to hatch. Open. You know, pick yourself out of your own shell. Our biggest infatuation is for the identity which we have formed as the one who is living life. And there is nobody living the life, you know. And if you are having this idea, I'm this particular person, and you are living life, you're making life happen in a certain way. This is a delusion, it's not true.
Catch it.
You cannot change your personality in a flash. But you can realize the self in a flash. It's not that somebody to change your personality. You need to understand who you are. You see everything. That's a phenomenal movement, which means that it is an object of perception. And when presence itself becomes an object of perception, then what can be said of that? Catch it at the root. That even the one who is making the projection is not the essence. It arises out of the essence. And then one comes to understand that oneself is the essence. And know that that essence itself is not suffering any delusion. And there is nobody living the life. You know?
Catch it on the root.
You cannot change your personality in a flash. But you can realize the self in a flash. It's not that somebody to change your personality. You need to understand who you are.
Catch it.
You see everything. That's is a phenomenon of movement, which means that it is an object of perception. And when presence itself becomes an object of perception, then what can be said of that? Thereafter, your words and your actions are the actions of the universe, because there's no independent motivator behind them, no personal one. You see, even if your sense is to be something personal, it can be overlooked because it really doesn't have the potency to germinate as a new seed anymore. It's kind of it's finished.
Catch it at the root.
You see everything as a phenomenal movement, which means that it is an object of perception. Then what can be said of that? This one which is I have to change is the one who is in the world. Rather than looking for the secondary experience, look for the primary experience.
Catch it at the root.
Quietly, something is erased out of your being, becomes redundant. I don't know if that is clear enough. Is it not the same? Voice that spoke inside my heart, speak inside your heart. So it's not the same thing. I think it's completely okay to feel this, to feel fear if it's there, to let it be felt. Allow the fear to happen first, otherwise you're using inquiry as a painkiller. Don't use it as a painkiller. Use it as an opportunity to kind of understand yourself. So let the fear come, let it happen first. You see? Don't try to prevent it. Don't say, there's no room in here for fear. Or for sadness or anger. Feel it. It's completely okay. And try and see if you can find some center. You can just be quiet with it and do.
Go inside your house, close your door, and whatever.
You will not find it. You will not find a particular center. It will keep shifting about. You cannot find a particular point in you that is suffering anything. Then it will come more clear in your being, not just to your mind, in your being, that it doesn't really exist. And that clarity of seeing is much more profound than thinking it out. You're feeling, you're seeing that it doesn't exist. You feel it, you see. You can start like that. Allow the fear to happen first. It's completely okay. It's like this, it's just like that. It's completely okay. Let anything happen, but don't identify. You don't gain something more by identifying.
You don't gain something more by identifying.
Even if identification happened, say, okay, there's still a space in you enough to say, but you know, that's just kind of happening. And it's like this. If you can find that space in yourself that allows this, that even if identification is taking place, something said, you know, it's like this, it's just like that. Allow the fear to happen first. It's completely okay. It's like this, it's just like that. You see, don't try to prevent it. Don't say, there's no room in here for fear. Feel it. Let anything happen, but don't identify. You don't gain something more by identifying.
There is no back out of this question. You can turn away and say, okay, you know what, I'm not in the mood for this now. I want to know what happens with you. You're cornered by this question. What happens with you? The time for procrastination is over, you know. Only direct seeing, confirming for yourself. Huh? And it need not be in words. No, I'm not looking for this. What have you discovered? If you've discovered something which comes and goes, it's not. This must be finished. Throw this away. And also the memory of it will go. Yeah. There is no back out of this question. You can turn away and say, okay, you know what? I want to know what happens with you. You're cornered by this question. What happens with you? Who can cope without a reference? Who will cope without a reference? This one they call Havanuta. The Havanuta. The one who is beyond relationships. A rare one. This question will somehow be dissolving all your attachments to thoughts and bodies. There is no back out of this question. You can turn away. I want to know what happens with you. You're cornered by this question. What happens with you? This question, it removes all my references. Who are you without references? So this question is removing you. And something is supremely happy about it. Because when you are not, everything is fine. When you, the illusion of yourself, is not anymore in the picture, then welcome to spontaneous being, spontaneous existence, unending joy, undiminishable peace. You are again the immortal being. This is your opportunity. Leave all the things that you think you know and come to the place where there's no knowledge. Go to the place prior to knowledge, before knowledge. Don't rely on your mind come to some conclusion. It means nothing at all, you see. If you want to know these things, you must start from now to stop knowing, stop relying on knowing. Come to a place of being prior to knowing. Speak from that place which cannot be known. Leave all the things that you think you know and come to the place where there is no knowledge even. Go to the place prior knowledge, before knowledge. Because you are before knowledge. This is why you know knowledge. And also you know ignorance. Even the most powerful tool you have, the power of your attention, so intimate is attention that you call it I. And yet you're earlier than attention because you can watch attention. You can even observe the lack of attention or inattention. So what is this from which all of that is perceived? What is this? Come to that place of recognition now. Leave all the things that you think you know and come to the place where there's no knowledge even. Go to the place prior to knowledge. It's not something located in time or at the end of some practice it will be awarded to you. Even if you make the most incredible practice and you get the most incredible gift, it will still only be a phenomenon. Recognize by your now present and ever present reality. What is this? Bring your attention to this place. And don't let the attention coming with any associates. Let your attention return naked with you. Don't bring any folders with you. And what is here now? Leave all the things that you think you know and come to the place where there's no knowledge even. Go to the place prior to knowledge. Speak from that place which cannot be known. Go to the place prior to knowledge. To that original innocence. Reject everything, including even your I. And see where you are. Leave everything. I have come to see you as that pure being. That's who you are for me. I want this to be clear for your own self that there's nothing about this here. Nothing else in residence of any worth here. I am not offering tenancy to any thought that is not in service to what is. Leave all the things that you think you know. Come to the place where there's no knowledge even. Go to the place prior to knowledge. Speak without your head. Chop your head off. I is consciousness. I is the godly voice and principle and presence within you. I is synonymous with presence. It is your intuitive self-knowing. I is consciousness.
It's arising from inside you. I am here, your home. I is consciousness. So even when there is an active focusing on something, it doesn't leave the grand seeing. Even that focus seeing can happen. You're inside the great seeing and nothing is lost. You see? Constantly, it's like an ever-changing self-portrait. It's always a work in progress.
Let the rain come down, let the sun shine on.
It has no fixed reality. You are the reality.
Let the rain come down, let the sun shine on.
Identity is playing, changing. Not fixed. It is affected by moods, also by time. It's not fixed. You are the root. I is consciousness. I is the godly voice and principle and presence within you.
Thank you. Springs out of one unicity. That is the one somehow manifesting as all this apparent diversity, relating to itself as otherness, and then coming to find that all this otherness springs out of one unicity, which is its own self. This understanding can come and will come. In the sense of separateness, then you may find that it springs up a new quote, naturally. An intuitive knowing that everything arises from one common source, and that source cannot be placed away from my intuitive sense of what I am. How can I be other than the source? You see? Maybe like this it will come to you. The question, who am I, is more intimate than who is God. What recognizes the changing costumes of I. What sees it? So the evidence that there is some power, deeper power of perception, that is capable of perceiving even I, is already there. What is this? Different from you? I think these questions are more intimate, more fundamental than who is God? Perhaps in coming to some deep understanding within yourself, that question will also be answered for you in a way that is without argument. The question, who am I, is more intimate than who is God? I found this the most unsparing question. Most ruthless at exposing the ego as completely a myth. What recognizes the changing costumes of I? What sees it? If you ask the question, who is God, and I could give the greatest answer, that is going to be satisfying for you. For how long will it be satisfying? It's here right now. Where else to be? That which causes the speaking and the listening and the comprehending to take place.
The sense I am purely is the godly principle in each form. All sentient beings feel intuitively the sense I exist, I am. You have to understand what this principle is, because it is constantly shifting shape. At one end, at the grosser end, this feeling, I am, is identified with the body and think it is the body. Then it becomes the body consciousness. Then you experience yourself as a material being, as just merely a physical being. You will go to war and fight against other physical beings for your belief. At the other end, still referring to itself as I, is the witness of all of this. And this witness, when it's not identified or associated with any condition, is felt like space, 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 space. Just the feeling I am is present, but it's not attached to any condition, to any thought. If spirituality or religion has any significance, it's only such that when it's sieved out, the feeling I am-ness, stop associating it with other concepts and ideas and simply marinates in its own self. And then great peace, great joy. When you feel the sense I am, it doesn't have any history. It has no psychological force. It's like pure space. It's empty. There's no residential concepts in it. Just like now you feel, even here, you're feeling the beauty of the I am. It's coming into its own. This is what we're coming to see. And in seeing this and recognizing the misunderstanding, you see, you are left alone again. And in this aloneness, this feeling I am, it's complete, just the sense I am. You can feel that. This is the very goal of spirituality, in fact, to find the feeling I am without association with anything else, with any concept or memory or intention or projection or desire or attachment or form. Feel this. Is somehow a clue. Must be a clue. Any intelligent person must say, well, wait a minute. I only suffer in this waking state. What must mankind do to be free? Mankind must become kind man. And Ramana Maharshi also say, all good qualities manifest spontaneously in the awakened mind. Inherently, all goodness is outpouring from you. It's still there now. The rest is only the outpourings of a dormant mind. My feeling is to remind you that state which is referred to by awakening or enlightenment, whatever. Often when we speak about it, we are referring to 2,000 years ago, 2,500 years ago, 7,000 years ago. So we are inclined to feel that this is an ancient thing that used to happen. But what we are is timeless. What we are is timeless. Timelessly perfect. It's not a compliment that I am paying to you. But it really is a mystery that being this effortless being, how this confusion came about. In the deep sleep, we're all equal. Who is the king? Who is the beggar in the deep sleep? You're not a man or a woman, or you have no religion, have no belief, nothing about bound or free. None of these things exist for you. There's no troubler. There's never been any crime committed in deep sleep. No marriage, no divorce, no children, no husband, no belief, no religion in deep sleep. You have to come to the waking state to have the taste of these. So what we call existence is really the waking state and the dreaming state. Isn't it incredible that as soon as the light of consciousness turns on, all of this show comes, this magic show of you and me and world and time and space, life and death, religions, belief, hatred, the idea of unity and diversity, all of this comes. Surely the deep sleep is somehow a clue. Must be a clue. Any intelligent person must say, wait a minute, I only suffer in this waking state. And I only am, so to speak, as I am in the waking state. Who are you? Without referring to the past, who are you right now? Is it not you, your own self? But what is it? What is it that does not belong to past or future or even present even, but is aware of all of these? Is it not you, your own self? You are not your self-image. For thousands of years, human beings have gathered together like this. Tangible will always change. It's fine
it belongs to what is changeful. But that in which the changeful is sweetness, can that be found? For thousands of years, human beings have gathered together like this, to research into this. Who are we? Where do I come from? What is my purpose? Who am I? Many in their physical aspect have come and gone, but they found that which doesn't come and go. Now we are here now at the very forefront of all this wave of humanity. Now this is our moment, our chance. What is your finding? Those who are to come are not yet here. You're here. Your time. Whatever is tangible will not stay. It is subject to change. Let change be. But change is weakness.
Yeah.
consciousness refers to themselves as I. You see, God says I, and the devil says I. Fallen for your own projection. Consciousness is in association with the mind and its conditioning, with the belief I am the body, and that conditioning. You didn't calculate that this one, the calculator, the one who is attempting to do something, is also just another feeling in something greater than that. All these sensations are occurring in awareness, you see. You are awareness itself. Refers to themselves as I. You are awareness itself. As long as you don't find out, you will continue being confused. Find out. A great assumption is already posing in the position of the I. No one questions it. Please, itself is a thought. But it's an intensely believed in thought. So much so that you will practice spirituality for another 100 years to come back to the point where you recognize that this one, this is the culprit. This is what the Buddha also found. This one, who for so long I thought I was, now is seen I am not.
Transcend all time. I transcend all space. I transcend all objects. I ever transcend everything. I am of the nature that has not an atom of conceit. I am of the nature that has not an atom of attachment. I am of the nature of the Immaculate Supreme Brahman Absolute. Inquire steadfastly into this every day. I am ever of the nature of truth. This I am. This I am. I am of the nature of changeless consciousness. This I am. All that exists is this alone. Beloved, know yourself to be this alone. I am of the nature of non-duality, without any second. This I am. All is this. Beloved, know yourself to be this only, and be happy. This world, this life, this existence, this is your dance. Dance your dance. Be happy. Remain without attachment. Remain without desire. And dance your dance. Remain in peace. And dance your dance. Remain free. Remain whole. Remain perfect. Remain as this and dance your dance. This is all there is. Just this. Be one with this. All this is only yourself. Not apart from you. Include all this. Dance your dance. Peace is your nature. joy is your nature. Dance your dance.